Just stay calm, okay? We're here for help. I'll go check on her, don't worry. Hey, we're gonna find him. It's okay. What do you mean? I thought that's when we met you. That's when he destroyed everything. How did you two out of everyone survive? Luigi, it took long enough for you to show. Yes, my friend is in danger.
And you gotta help us!
The earliest known occurrence of SMNH dates back to prehistoric times in a universe inhabited by Yoshis. SMNH took the form of a giant Yoshi and completely destroyed everything. Everyone, except two Yoshis. It's popular belief that SMNH is not a single being, but rather a being that exists in all universes. No matter how different his hate for other things are in other universes, one thing always stays the same. He wants to take control. SMNH has existed forever, however, SMNG brought him back to life. SMNG's creator made him and his universe. Okay, this is so damn confusing. So SMNH has existed this whole time, but also hasn't? Like me just showing up somehow woke him up and caused him to wake up in the past? How does that work? Well, now that I know his background, I need to get SMNP back.
Oh, now there's a prophecy.
Well, I'm off to save SMNP.
I can't believe that I actually got away with this. This is amazing. You, my friend, are stuck with me forever. I won. Now, who could that be? Spider-Man? What are you doing here?
I'm here because I heard you got a nice collection of artifacts I'd like to look at.
Well, that's certainly true.
So, you wouldn't mind if I looked around?
Of course not. Spider-Man's my favorite superhero. Go right ahead.
Thank you. Now, where could he be? There he is. I've never heard you so quiet before. If only you could always say this quiet. Anyways, let's get you out of this form.
What's going on here, Spider-Man? Why are you here?
Because I'm not Spider-Man. This was just the only disguise I had laying around. Don't worry, everyone's fine. We got help from Luigi, and now he's gonna try and save Mario.
Have fun with that.
What?
I knew you weren't Spider-Man.
Well, if you did, then you're pretty damn stupid.
You fell into my trap. Now it's over.
Wait, before you kill us, let us-
Kill you? You aren't even done with your main objective yet.
What do you mean? We covered every Mario movie and show, except for the new one, but there's no way that counts because we started this before it came out.
Well, there aren't any more Mario shows, but there's one Nintendo show that I just know SMNP is dying to cover. Oh yeah? Like what? The Donkey Kong Country show.
No way, that's not a Mario show.
Donkey Kong is a Mario character, don't forget that. Well, since Donkey Kong was the first game Mario was in, wouldn't that mean that Mario is technically a Donkey Kong character?
You aren't helping my case.
Anyways, you guys have exactly 24 hours to come up with some sort of review of that show.
Or
everyone dies. Everyone dies because of you two.
Great. Just great.
Well, better get to it. clock is ticking, starting now.
Okay, I'm the biggest Donkey Kong fan in the world. I beat Donkey Kong Country on the Switch before, so I think I got this.
I'm not sure that makes you qualified for this job.
I also have the Super Nintendo version, in case you're wondering.
But we're supposed to be working together.
Can you, like, shut up?
Okay, fine.
Good. We have to give out plenty of information about our topic. Let's talk about Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong is a gorilla. That's about it.
Oh, come on. He's not gonna be satisfied with that.
He's never satisfied with anything. He just mopes around his palace all the time. Fine. Let me try it again. Donkey Kong is very important when it comes to the history of video games because his first game also happens to be the first game with Super Mario in it. Although his name wasn't Mario in the game, it was a Jumpman. The point of the game is that Donkey Kong kidnapped a girl named Pauline, and Mario, or Jumpman, has to save her. Also, I think this game entirely takes place at a construction site. Like, there are so many ladders and barrels and hammers, so this is a public occurrence. Why don't they just get the military involved or something?
Okay, that should be good.
No, we gotta really satisfy him. We have to make sure he understands everything about Donkey Kong.
We're gonna be here for a while.
I'm giving SMNH a Donkey Kong history lesson. A summary of everything related to Donkey Kong. Well, not everything, or else you would be here all day. I'll just talk about every Donkey Kong game, especially Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. Donkey Kong was such a popular game in the arcades that it got ported to the Atari 2600. What the fuck is this? That is not Donkey Kong. That's a fucking gingerbread man. No, that's the ginger dead man right there. The Atari port was a disaster, but what else would you expect from the console that brought us Dolphin? 1 year later, an actual sequel to the game was released. Sequel in quotation marks here. Donkey Kong Jr. This raises a lot of questions. Who did Donkey Kong...
Whoa, that's a bit of a risky joke, don't you think?
No.
Anyways, back to where I was before I was so rudely interrupted. The point of Donkey Kong Jr. is that Mario pulled the ultimate Uno reverse card and kidnapped Donkey Kong. So it's up to Donkey Kong's son to save him. I have no idea what the story of this game is supposed to be. Why and how did Mario take Donkey Kong? Why are they in what appears to be a jungle? When did Mario get the time or resources to make gravity-defying obstacles? Why was this the sequel to Donkey Kong? If you ever feel useless, remember that Donkey Kong 3 exists. What is the point of this game? Who saw the last game and said,
"Oh man, I need more of that"?
The story of this game is that Donkey Kong is trying to get into this guy's garden. And who the fuck is this dork? This is Stanley, the protagonist of this game. He uses pesticide to spray Donkey Kong. Why are all of these games just about Donkey Kong getting violated? My guess is Nintendo just really hated monkeys. Released the same year as Donkey Kong 3's Donkey Kong Jr. Math. Oh fuck, they're evolving! Why is this allowed? Why can they do math now? This game confuses the hell out of me. Like, this game sucks ass, but it is important because it was the first Donkey Kong game released exclusively on a game console and not an arcade. Then the video game industry fucking died.
Okay, I think the point has been proven. Donkey Kong is important, and I think we should get on with the actual review.
But we just got to the good part! Now, the next Donkey Kong game didn't come out for 11 whole years. What was Nintendo doing? But thankfully, the franchise came back with a bank. See, Nintendo realized that Donkey Kong Jr. Math was kind of fucking garbage, so they completely changed the kind of game Donkey Kong was. The previous DK games were all kind of the same and had similar game designs. The only kind of unique one was Donkey Kong 3, but I'd rather battle kidney stones than interact with that game. This new game was very different, gameplay-wise and graphic-wise. In 1994, Donkey Kong Country was released for the Super Nintendo, and this game looked so good for a game on the Super Nintendo. Everything looked and sounded so clean. This is the same franchise as The Plague? This game is amazing. Donkey Kong is no longer being abused by Italians or gardeners. He's the main star of the game alongside his nephew Diddy Kong. Well, technically, this isn't the same DK as in the previous game. So this is Donkey Kong Jr. kinda. And this guy, Cranky Kong, is actually the original Donkey Kong. But when you do the math, that doesn't really make sense, assuming that DK was the youngest 30 years old during the original game and that his son was realistically around 10 years old during the second game, which should ideally take place at like a year later. Considering that in Donkey Kong Country, DK Jr. looks like the original DK, I'd assume he'd also be around 30 years old. So there would be a 20-year time jump, probably, meaning that Cranky Kong, aka the original Donkey Kong, should be around 50 years old. But gorillas ideally live up to 40 years. I feel bad for the monkey researcher at Nintendo.
Oh fuck, they can die?
Donkey Kong Country not only changed the concept of Donkey Kong games, but also had a major impact on games in general. This game is one of the most unique platformers I've ever played. Sure, it's just like other platformer games in a way. Go from point A to point B and stomp off enemies. But the reason I say this is unique is because of its tag team system. See, in games like Super Mario Bros., there's multiplayer, but it's really just taking turns. It's not really a co-op experience. In Donkey Kong Country, you play as Donkey Kong or Diddy Kong, and if one of them gets knocked out, you can play as the other. Then, if you find a barrel, you can throw it to spawn the other player in again. Even if you're playing single player, you can still swap between the two gorillas with ease, and I've always liked that. The story of this game is that this guy, King K. Rool, stole all of the Kong's family's bananas.
You can't keep getting away with it!
So, Donkey Kong and his family decided the only way to get bananas back is manslaughter. But you don't just stop on critters, you can also ride in minecarts or ride on animals. This game is known for being pretty challenging, but it wasn't that bad. I just got a bit mad at times. But it rewards a skilled player. So yeah, this game kind of changed Donkey Kong. Everyone knows this guy in his iconic form. We no longer have to deal with old pixel guy here. While this guy is getting into games like Smash Bros. And Mario Kart, this guy is stuck in Adam Sandler movies. But there is something else that this show inspired.
No.
Donkey Kong Country TV show. Yeah, this is what we're going to be talking about. Now, I'll give you some time to click off this video and keep your sanity. This show exists for some reason. This thing lasted from 1997 until 2000. Why? Why did it last so long? Why did this get 40 episodes? I guess I have to give credit where credit is due because this show is entirely animated using a computer. As a matter of fact, this was the first ever show animated by using only motion capture. So these are real people doing these movements. So that means the show is of historical value. That'd be like if the first people on the moon were Lil Bow Wow and Pete Davidson. That ain't nothing to be proud of. They spent $1 in the actual animation and they got all rewarded for that. No amount of money can make me do this. Anyways, this show is the reason we are all in this mess in the first place. So I think it's time for me and SMNG to actually watch it.
Finally, I get something to do. I've just been listening to you talk about Donkey Kong.
And what have you learned?
I learned that you should focus on reviewing the damn show before everything gets destroyed by SMNH.
Okay, that's fair. Let's watch the first episode of the show and see if we have a pulse afterwards.
Look, the crystal. They'll explain it all.
That's Donkey Kong, the strongest, brawniest, hippest ape in all of Congo Bongo. Our protector and future king. Got a lot of muscle mass.
Why is Cranky Kong explaining who Donkey Kong is? I hope he would know who his son is. Or is he talking to the audience? But even then, why have someone explain everything about the main character? Why not just, oh I don't know, write scenes with the main character doing stuff? This is just crazy writing.
That slimy, scaly, foul breath lizard, King K. Rool, professional bad guy, the big daddy of evil. Kroon, he's here.
Sure, let's just explain every character. Who needs an actual story with character development when we can just jump right in the middle of the story and get the Cliff Notes version of what's going on with no further information? That's great!
I'm just an underprivileged reptile. A little late on my genes.
So King K. Rool's plan gets ruined by Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong, and instead of going home and coming up with a better strategy, he just jumps down and kills himself. Well, I know he didn't kill himself because it's a kid's show, but there's no way he survived that fall.
We didn't add that sound effect. That's actually in the show. It sounds like something that would play in an old Scooby-Doo cartoon. Also, why is the general running away like his life depends on it? He's wearing a helmet. If that helmet can't provide support for a falling book, then this army really needs to step up their budget.
While cutting the obnoxious lout's hair, chant snip, clip, power slip. You're a wimp and that's it. He'll be left as weak as a baby and...
I like how all the words in the book are just gibberish. I can't tell if that was a mistake or someone got really lazy and just ran their hand across their keyboard.
How original, Bluster.
Yes, I am a thoughtful son of a gun. Happy birthday. Banana cream, your favorite.
Rejected. Watching my figure.
Don't bother. I'm watching it for you.
I don't think so.
The machine! No! No! That was close.
So, are we gonna go back to my place on the Copa Banana, or what?
I made plans.
With him?
Hi, Donkey Kong.
Happy birthday, Candy!
You can't be serious.
I try to do nice things, but
I brought you these! Ooh, I was gonna get you a cake, but I see you already got one.
So this guy with the mustache made Candy Kong a cake, and she didn't want it. So he just smashed it onto her hand. So he assaulted her. They should lock him up. Wait, I just thought about something. If her last name is Kong, doesn't that mean she's related to DK somehow? Is Donkey Kong Country actually in Alabama?
Hopla, pain in the butt!
Yes!
Oh. You're out of here!
I guess this means our date's off, huh?
Bitch! Donkey Kong came on your birthday to surprise you with a bunch of bananas and that's it. He wasn't trying to flirt with you or pressure you into eating cake like that mustache monkey was. Speaking of him, he assaulted you. Why are you getting mad at Donkey Kong and not the man to shove the cake into your face? Well, that was the first episode of the Donkey Kong Country TV show.
What do you mean? That was only half the episode.
I physically cannot watch any more of it. It actually hurts my soul to watch this.
Fine, I kind of agree. So what are your thoughts on it?
I don't think it's horrible. It's just really weird and cringy, and the animation hurts to look at. Every time one of these characters moves in the screen, I just want to throw up.
Well, look at it this way. If this show never existed, we never would have gotten movies and shows such as King Kong, Rampage, Sid the Science Kid, and the list goes on and on.
I mean, King Kong has existed since 1933, and Rampage is based on an arcade game from 1986, but funnily enough, you are correct about Sid the Science Kid. Speaking of that, remember in math class when you watched Sid the Science Kid memes all the time?
What are you talking about? We never went to school together. I've only known you for 2 years.
You're right. Why did I just remember something that never even happened?
I don't know, but you seem uneasy. Maybe we should just give this review to SMNH and get this whole thing over with.
That's what he wants. But I think we should go back to Luigi and the Inklings first and see what they discovered.
Alright, but remember, we have to show SMNH the review within 24 hours.
I know. I just need to say hi to Liz.
I have a quick question for you.
What's that?
It seems like you haven't been yourself lately.
What do you mean?
Be honest with me. Tell me everything. Why have you been slipping up so much lately? Why do you really fear SMNH?
I've been experiencing things from the past.
I thought you never existed until 2021.
I didn't, but I'm remembering things that I was something, someone else.
Well, don't let it bother you too much. It's kind of strange, but let's just continue.
Yeah, I'm back. I missed you too.
Fellas, fellas, I am so horny!
How's everything going with Finding Mario? Well, if I know him well enough, he isn't gonna be stuck.
Hey guys, good to see you again.
Hell yeah, nice to see you too, man.
I brought him back.
I'll have two number nines.
Well, I'd love to stay, but I need to get this video to SMNH.
Well, you are looking at the fastest thing in the world. I will take it.
Thanks, Sonic. Well, I guess it's time for bed. I mean, I'm really tired. I don't know about you guys. I'm going to bed.
And of course, there are no rooms left for me. Unless...
Hey, Liz, you think I could stay in this room tonight?
Thanks. What else do you really want to know about me? My story isn't a happy one. It hurts to talk about. Well, there is one thing I want to say. I like you, Liz. I mean, I really like you. Really? Thank you, Liz. You're probably one of the only people who likes me.
Ow, what the hell? Someone shot me!
Oh my god, somebody shot him!
Oh my god!
No!
What's going on now? We gave you the video.
I don't care about that anymore. I'm taking something else from you. You thought you won?
You son of a bee!
What the hell just happened?
What happened is that SMNH has officially crossed the line. He's trying to take everything he can from me and personally ruin my life. Sonic, Luigi, come with me. Bring powers and the rainbow stars. Let's go.
SMNP, I can see you. What do you want? I just want to talk to you.
You shot me.
I'm sorry, but that was just a reminder that you shouldn't be hanging around SMNG and his group.
You can't make me.
You think you're tough? Need I remind you who your creator is? And you use me to go against him. Obviously, dumbass, me shooting you just made you stronger and changing you. Can you feel it? No, yes, master. Come back over to my side.
They should be coming sometime soon. Don't mess this up, Pete.
I won't, master. I like to hear that. I see our guests arriving. Go out and greet them.
You guys should just give up.
What? How are you here?
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Okay, guys, listen to me. Mario and Luigi, you go after P. Sonic, you go after H. And I'll try to save the Inklings.
Try catching these heads!
Try outrunning that.
What happened? Was I too quick?
No, I'm just getting warmed up!
Why can't I teleport?
Ha! Gotta try harder.
I must kill you. Did you think that would work?
Mario!
SMNH, I know you can hear me. Give me Kara and Liz, now.
You're finally admitting your defeat?
I'm not admitting my defeat. I don't care if I die trying to get them back. I will.
I like you. You try to be a hero. But where does that really get you?
It'll lead to my success.
Now I can't fly. You will pay. There's nothing I can do to help.
Oh my god, hey SMNG.
What?
They got dinosaurs from Jurassic Park and Super Mario World. Can you believe they did out here? But Yoshi's in this one, so be careful.
This isn't a tier list, you know. Tell him, P.
I'm helping him now. I know what I did was wrong or something like that. What can I do? I'll be back.
Stop this now!
SMNP, help me, please.
SMNP, you traitor. I'm no longer in your control. You've lost. Well, P, I thought we had finally gotten you on our side. Unfortunately, it seems that you're just a fraud. I trusted you. I don't care. I'm helping my friends. Well, you helped him for the last time. Our pal DK seems angry. He hates traitors. Goodbye, SMNP. You failed me and your friends.
No. No. No!
I'll leave you to mourn your dead friend in peace. This is the whole party in an indestructible force field. I'll leave you alone. I have a universe to go take over. To the airship.
I failed. What the hell? Whoa, who the hell are you?
SMNP didn't tell you about me?
Oh my god, you're his past self he was talking about.
Great guess, I'm Neon. Now, let me guess something. SMNP died.
Well, obviously.
I'm good at these guessing games, but I'm just good at games in general. Oh, you know, if you ever want to play Monopoly.
I appreciate it, but this really isn't the right time. We need to chase after that airship.
Oh, let's go.
Get to the truck.
How are we going to get to him?
There's only one way we can do this.
Oh no, you're crazy.
I'm not crazy. I'm just doing what I need to do.
No one can stop me now. You finally did it.
Just never quit on you. I mostly did this for you. So, Neon, any idea of where you're going after all this?
No idea. In a world full of Nintendo characters, I'm just a regular person.
Well, if you ever need somewhere to stay, then I'm fine with you staying at my place.
I appreciate it, but I don't need no help right now. I'll figure it out on my own. Does your house have internet?
Yes.
Okay, I'm moving in.
That was a bit too fast of an answer.
Sorry, I just really need the internet. So, what are you gonna do with your life now?
I mean, I think I'm just gonna live here and help expand on the Mushroom Kingdom, maybe help the Kong Islands or build a village for all the hedgehogs.
Sounds good. I'll see you later.
Goodbye, Mario and Luigi. I'll probably see you two tomorrow.
Bye.
Come on, Kara. Let's go home. And that's that. That's the end of the SMNG story. I hope you all enjoyed this. This was the longest, most stressful, and toughest video I've ever made, but I've never been more satisfied with it, and I'm really happy I could close this out, not the way I intended, but close enough. I hope you will follow us on our new journey here on Shield Garage 5, where we will continue racing content, car-related things, and other gameplays that I like to put on my main channel, like Call of Duty Black Ops 2, for NASCAR 14, but for now, it's good night and farewell to the channel that started it all, SMNG5.
When you make new friends in a brand new town, and you start to think about settling down. The things that would have been lost on you are now clear as a bell. And you find yourself, yeah, that's when you find yourself. Well, you go through life so sure of where you're heading, and you wind up lost, and it's the best thing that could have happened. 'Cause sometimes when you lose your way, it's really just as well. When you meet the one that you've been waiting for, and she's everything that you want and more, you look at her and you finally start to live for someone else. And then you find yourself, that's when you find yourself. We go through life so sure of where we're heading, and then we wind up lost, and it's the best thing that could have happened. Sometimes when you lose your way, it's really just as well. 'Cause you find yourself, yeah, that's when you find yourself.